This is an overview and demonstration of AWS OpsWorks. OpsWorks is a DevOps application management solution. If you develop or manage applications, you know they can be complex. And not just to code, there are operational responsibilities too. These tasks need to be predictable. There's nothing worse than trying to diagnose operational problems in your live app. You want to be able to configure and control any aspect of your application. You need a tool that's powerful and flexible enough to support a wide range of application architectures. And you also want something that's easy to use. We developed OpsWorks for you. OpsWorks is an integrated application management solution. It brings together all the tools you need to manage your application. Perhaps best of all, you only pay for the resources you use. OpsWorks itself is free. Why should you use OpsWorks? Simply put, OpsWorks makes your life easier because it's simple. It includes a management console, CLIs, and SDK with built-in support for common frameworks and tasks. It makes you more productive. It includes an integrated experience to model and reproduce the application configuration reliably. It's also flexible. It supports a wide variety of application architectures and any software that has a scripted installation. It's powerful. With an event-driven configuration system with support for customizable deployments, rollback, patch management, auto-scaling, and more. And finally, it's secure. OpsWorks is one of a few ways you can deploy apps on AWS. I'll briefly introduce the other application management services and describe how OpsWorks is different. It really comes down to the level of convenience and control you need. Elastic Beanstalk is an easy-to-use solution for building web apps and web services. If you want to upload your code and go, and don't need to customize your environment, Beanstalk may be for you. CloudFormation is a building block service that lets you provision and manage almost any AWS resource via domain-specific language. It's powerful, but it requires you to author templates in a domain-specific language and doesn't provide out-of-the-box application functionality like deployments. On the other hand, OpsWorks is a powerful end-to-end solution. It gives you an easy way to manage applications of nearly any scale and complexity without sacrificing control. It features an integrated experience for managing the complete application lifecycle, including resource provisioning, configuration management, application deployment, software updates, monitoring, and access control. What we're going to show you in the demonstration today is how to model the application in OpsWorks, starting with a stack that contains all the resources we're going to use. Next, we'll create a layer. A layer is a blueprint for how we configure our EC2 instances. We'll create two layers, a PHP layer for our PHP app and a MySQL layer for our database. We'll then create some instances. Instances can be on all the time, or they can scale based on load from your application. And finally, our application will be deployed onto those instances. Now, our application, like many, needs to connect to a database for persistence. How can we create and configure the database and then make sure our application connects to it? The old way would be we'd create the database table by hand and then bake the connection information into the code. This can be error-prone because you can miss a step or later forget what you did when you need to recreate it. We really want configuration information such as the database table creation, user creation, and all the metadata about the database to be managed like our source code. That way we can roll it back just like source code changes. And fortunately, Chef gives us a way to do this. OpsWorks triggers events during the application lifecycle, such as when an instance is provisioned or an application is deployed. This lets you perform specific configuration tasks using Chef recipes that are attached to those events. Metadata is automatically generated by OpsWorks for such information as the instances running in each layer and layer-specific parameters. You can also specify metadata yourself that's passed into the recipes. Let's take a look at an example. We probably need to create a database table for all the information our app is going to generate. We could do it ourselves by hand, but we'd like to automate it and ensure repeatability. So we write a recipe. The recipe would be brittle if we hard-coded information like the username and database name, so we define those as metadata and pass it into the recipes. Chef takes some metadata and plugs it into the recipe. We can see, for example, in this metadata example, that database, my PHP app, is defined as root, and it becomes uroot in the command below. Okay, let's jump into the demonstration. I'm going to go ahead and create my stack in OpsWorks. And we can see that each stack has a number of parameters, such as default operating system, the region, the default availability zone, and things like SSH key and hostname theme. We also can define custom cookbooks for our recipe. Now I'm going to go ahead and use cookbooks that I've defined in my cookbook repository. I'm going to go ahead and copy the repository information and paste it into my repository URL field here. OpsWorks supports a number of repository types, including Git and Subversion, as well as things like HTTP bundles and S3 bundles. I'll go ahead and create my stack. Now the next thing to do is to create the two layers that I need. I need a layer for my PHP app. This defines the instances configuration for the PHP app server, as well as a layer for my MySQL database. Now let's go ahead and start some instances here, and then I'll tell you a little bit more about the layers. And I'll just start these instances my default availability zone, although I could pick another availability zone as well. And I'll start all those instances. Now let's look at the layers in a little bit more detail. So I'll edit my PHP app server layer, and we can see that OpsWorks includes a number of built-in chef recipes. These recipes will configure the EC2 instances I create to include things like PHP, Apache web server, and a number of other things that help configure your application server for you. And then, of course, we want to be able to connect our PHP app to our database. And we've created a recipe that helps us do that. Let's go ahead and take a look at that recipe. And this basically passes in the parameters so that I can connect to the correct host with the username and password that I need and connect to the right table. So I'll go ahead and put my recipe name right here, and I'll add that. We can also see a couple other things that our layer can do. We can create EBS volumes that will be attached to all the instances that are created in this layer, even specifying things like RAID numbers and where you get those mounted. We could associate Elastic IPs with each of your instances. We could even add additional OS packages when the instance is created and booted. So we don't need any of these for this set of instances. So I'll go ahead and just click Save. And now let's go and take a look at our MySQL layer. We also have a recipe in our cookbooks for MySQL. And this takes care of setting up the database for us. It does the create table. So we'll go ahead and attach that to our deploy event here. And what this does is when OpsWorks gives a deploy event in our life cycles, then it'll execute the PHP app DB setup recipe. And here we can see that we already have a volume that's going to be attached to the instances in my MySQL layer, which makes sense. I need a place to store my database data. And you can also see just a couple other things I didn't mention before, such as the default security group that we have for this layer, all the instances in the layer. And you can create additional security groups and add those here as well. Auto-healing is a nice feature that OpsWorks has that will allow you to restart instances in this layer in case of any instance failures. So now that I've defined my layers and I'm starting up my instances, let's talk a little bit about the instances themselves. So the instances that I've created are the type 24/7, which means they're on all the time. I can also create instances that will start when I have certain load-based thresholds. So for example, if I want to make sure that my app can handle the scale of information that's coming at it, then I can define additional instances to start when CPU thresholds are crossed, average memory thresholds are crossed, or average load. Some apps have regular load that comes at them based on time of day, and so you can also start time-based instances. And these instances allow you to schedule the instance start and stop based on the time of the day on certain days of the week or every day. So if I wanted an application to scale for a couple hours, then I could go ahead and start those instances just during those time windows. Okay, so now I've created the app server and the database server, but I still have to get my application onto it. And so that's where the apps area comes in handy. So I'll go ahead and add an app, and this is going to be my app. So I have source code for it, and I know that it's type PHP because that's the app server that I've just created. And I have that my app configured in another repository on GitHub, and I'll go ahead and just copy that repo URL. I know I want to deploy it on the web document root, and I'll paste in my repo information. Now, if this repo was private, then I could input my GitHub deploy SSH key. If it was a Subversion repo, then I could put in a username and password. I could put in some access keys if it was S3. All that's certainly possible. So you can have public as well as private repos. And then I'm going to go ahead and put version 2 in here because I have I'm using the version 2 branch for my application. And I'll go ahead and add this app. So the next thing I want to do is I'll actually want to deploy the app. And when I deploy the app, it's going to take the app's code from my repository, and it's going to go ahead and push it into the PHP app server. Okay, so we'll go ahead and click on the deploy button. And we can see that we have a number of commands here. So the standard command is to deploy, but we also have some other commands that we can run, and OpsWorks will execute the recipes that will cause those events to happen. And you can see that OpsWorks by default is going to go ahead and deploy this PHP app to the PHP app server, but you can see that MySQL is also selected. That's because we're going to send a deploy event to the MySQL servers as well, and we're going to run those deploy recipes that we configured before. So we'll want to go ahead and let both of those servers get the deploy event. We can see that the deploy is actually happening and executing on those servers. And before long, we'll actually see some log files here, which will give us a little bit more insight into the sorts of things that have been happening on those servers. Okay, so we can see that now there's a log for my MySQL, and we can, if we select it, we can see all the information about what's happened as far as the deployment, the chef recipes that were executed, and this is pretty handy for being able to take a look at any problems you might be having with deployments as you're doing your test and debugging. And now that both deployments have finished, I can go ahead and click on my instance, and let's take a look at the application. So it looks like my application's come up, and this is just a very basic application that allows us to put something into the database. So we'll just put in hello world and add our name here. And if we go back, oh, there we go. So what do we do here? Well, we saw that we could create a stack which contains all the resources used for a particular application. And my application consists of two layers, a PHP app server as well as a MySQL database. And those layers are interdependent. So I want to be able to configure my MySQL database with the table that I need, and then I want to be able to configure my app server and my app to be able to connect to that MySQL database. And I did that using chef recipes. And then I deployed the actual MySQL app, of which I could have many, in this little apps area. Now, one thing I didn't mention is how do you actually connect to the individual EC2 instances in case you want to be able to perform some maintenance on them or take a look at configuration details on the instances. And in general, typically what people do is they have an SSH key that's associated with each instance. OpsWorks gives you a little bit more flexibility. In the permissions area, I can import IAM users, and then I can give individual IAM users SSH or sudo access. And those IAM users can put their keys into the My Settings area. So they can put their public key into the My Settings, and then they can connect directly to each instance that they've been given access to using their private key. So just a little bit more control than giving each instance its own access key. Thank you very much for joining us today for this demonstration. If you'd like a little bit more information, including FAQs and links to forums and documentation, please visit us on the web at aws.amazon.com/opsworks.